senso, this is my temporary office.
Senta, so
I'm transferring to the old office. I think they are renovating and they thought that they're going to win and make us longer. So, for whatever it is, for experience, this is an update for them.
So I think it's quite symbolic, so it's not just, as far as I understand, it's not just the renovation of this building, but it's the renovation of the people in Manila, so in this respect, so I also wish you, as a mayor, had a success in all your efforts, in all your endeavors, in all your communities. By the way, so I hope you have already received the congratulatory letter of your Russian counterpart, Mayor of Moscow, Mr. Sobyanin.
Okay, thank you, your Excellency.
So this is a copy of our note, because according to the protocol, of course, we must send official correspondence from the Department of Foreign Affairs.
Okay.
So this is a copy, and this is a translation, and this is a copy of the congratulatory letter of your Russian counterpart, Mayor of Moscow, Mr. Sobyanin.
Thank you.
This is the translation. And there is another letter on the head of the Department for Foreign Relations of the Moscow government with a kind of invitation to the educational agency, the educational agency in Manila, and an educational, international educational event in Moscow at the end of August. So,
thank you.
Have you received? Have you received that? I think that is.
Can I have
from the DFI? Yes, it's for you.
Oh, thank you, thank
so,
you.
So I prepared it.
Thank you,
for you, just in case.
Thank you very much.
So, and in this respect, so I can.
And I like the color. It's blue. Sorry, pardon my appearance, Your Excellency. I'm having a toothache, so I have a swollen face in my right face.
Oh, I'm sorry to hear that,
but I cannot stop working, you know.
If so, in my humble view, so you look very well.
Oh, thank you.
Of course, it's better for ladies, of course, says that. But in my humble view, so
thank you
so
very much.
Everything is okay. So, Mr. Mayor, my message is very simple. So I think it's time to establish new ties between Moscow and to be frank, so your predecessor, my president, my president, he was invited a few times, several times to visit Moscow. So I think it's time to go to Moscow.
I love to visit Moscow.
Have you ever been to Moscow?
Connecting flight alone, inside the airport. In a tube.
It's almost
like, I think that was 2-3 o'clock in the morning, so I have to wait for 4 hours flying to New York. From Netherlands to Moscow to New York. So I took the stopover for 4 hours. I slept in the tube. You have this massage tube in the airport. So I slept there. That's the only thing that I know about Moscow. And I love to stay in Moscow.
Okay, but it's a
given
good
a chance.
Yeah. So I think it's time to discover Moscow. It's time to establish new ties of partnership with your Russian counterpart, Sergei Sobyanin. And I think there is a good opportunity for that. So for your information, every October, Moscow hosts a big international energy event, Energy Week. And the Moscow government organizes the so-called Summit of Mayors. Of Mayors on energy efficiency. On the sidelines of the International Energy Week. You know, Russia is a great energy superpower. So, and my president Estrada was invited a few times to attend the International Energy Week in Moscow, but unfortunately he couldn't go. So, if you have an interest, if you are interested in attending, so I'm ready to help. So, I'm ready to
register
the Moscow government to send an official invitation to you.
Yes, please.
This October. In October, the weather in Moscow is quite good.
Okay.
It's not very cold for Filipinos. Very good.
Good thing that you're going to invite me on my birthday.
So it's a good idea to celebrate your birthday.
In Moscow.
In the Kremlin.
Yeah, I would love to work during my birthday, especially abroad.
Yes, and it will be a good opportunity for you and your Russian counterpart, my Sergei Sobyanin, to exchange views, to exchange experience, and to see what should be done to make Manila and Moscow closer to each other, despite the geographical distance. Moscow is a very dynamic city, so it's developing very well. It's one of the biggest megacities in the world, and I'm sure that you have a lot of things to discuss.
And I've been reading a lot about Putin. I've been, you know, used to be a local chief executive.
Yeah.
So I try to, you know, go back into history of him being mayor of a largest city in your country.
Oh, so yes, Vladimir Putin used to be a vice mayor.
Deputy mayor,
of St. Petersburg, mm-hmm. The second largest city.
Yes.
So Moscow and St. Petersburg, they are very different from each other, but both are very different.
I'd love to go, Your Excellency. Especially, you're the one personally inviting. How come? I cannot decline that offer. It's an opportunity for the people of Manila, for us to learn something, especially in this clean and renewable energy.
Yes, energy, yes, ecological focus of also. I think it will be useful to change experience on how to solve ecological problems. Because leading up to the problems, it exists everywhere. Because energy efficiency is all aspects of the city development.
We think it's timely because I already directed our Division of City Schools to come up with clean energy, renewable energy with regard to our 104 public elementary and high school buildings. We are now on that direction next year. God's time, maybe we can achieve that goal. To inculcate the minds of our students. This is the long-term, the cleanest way to harness the energy of the sun and the water. There's one with our water, while it is something is our problem in the streets, we can also make it an advantage to come up with reusable water for regular needs in the school, whether it's garden or in the toilet. There are things that we can be more efficient. I can learn that from Russian government.
Yes, I think Moscow has a lot of experience in all of these fields. And I would like also to draw your attention once again to the second letter. The letter of the Minister of Moscow City Government, Head of the Department of External Economic and International Relations, Mr. Chirilov. So he kindly invites the head of the City Education Department to attend on the Moscow International Educational Week. So
sure,
it will be held in Moscow from 29 to September 6. And and within the framework of that educational week, so there will be another quite interesting event. From the International Olympiad of Megacities, will be held in Moscow from September 1 to September 6. So, and there will be a competition in mathematics, computer science, chemistry, and physics. So, and the team of Manila, so 8 school children from 14 to 18 years.
It's not for you, it's for your school children and their teachers.
Mm-hmm. So please, I'm kind of asking you to study attentively this letter and to see whether it's possible or not to send your school children to attend this event in Moscow.
Yes.
So, of course, your delegation will be most welcome.
Thank you.
Will be most welcome in Moscow. So, if I understand you correctly, so now my duty is to ensure to provide an official invitation to you.
Yes, for October. I'll be there.
Okay.
That's a commitment.
Okay.
I'd love to see that.
Okay, I'm happy to hear that. And this. I would like to emphasize that the Russian embassy and the office of the mayor of Manila, so we have been maintaining good contacts. Yes, we highly appreciate it, we highly value that. And please consider the Russian embassy here in Manila as your partner and friend.
Thank you.
If you have any idea, any suggestion, any proposal that you can develop,
any help
between our two capitals, between Manila and Moscow, please don't hesitate.
The same thing is being offered to you by the city of Manila, Your Excellency. Anything that we can extend as a city government, we'll be happy to serve.
Okay, thank you so much. And once again, I sincerely wish you any success.
Thank you.
With all your endeavors.
Thank you, Your Excellency. Guys, thank you.
Okay, and according to the Russian tradition, so I have a modest Russian.
Mr. Ambassador, you and the mayor will invite you to Bulwark.
Our people's hall.
Okay. Okay.
Thank you.
I was in Russia
2 years ago.
It's my simple stuff.
Oh, very good.
I went to Russia.
We go to Russia.
Very excellent. Subway, sir.
Thank you.
ko na si
Do you have any
questions
that you discussed during your meeting with the mayor?
Thank you. Good morning. Thank you very much for your question. So first of all, I would like to explain the purpose of my visit. The main purpose of my visit, Honorable Mr. Mayor, is to see what can and should be done in order to establish new contacts of partnership and cooperation between Manila City and the city of Moscow. So I'm deeply convinced that Manila and Moscow will take care of many common problems to be solved, and both the two cities have a lot of experience to change, and I'm sure that the change of experience, exploration of new opportunities for cooperation will be very useful for people living in both Manila and Moscow. And the first step of this way, of course, is to establish direct contacts between the mayor of Manila and the mayor of Moscow. And we discuss what can and should be done on this track.
Sir, you mentioned that you have common problems. Manila and Moscow have common problems. Can you mention some of these
challenges? Well, problems and challenges are quite usual, of course. For example, traffic, ecology, of course, energy efficiency, social sphere, education, public health, and the others. So it's quite common. All big cities are facing similar challenges. And many challenges are quite complicated. And it's time to combine our efforts to efficiently cope with those challenges. First of all, I would like to emphasize that we attach a great importance to the establishment of direct ties between different Russian and Philippine cities. But at the same time, I believe that first of all, in the first place, we should establish good ties of cooperation between the city of Manila and the city of Moscow. So they should show a good post example to all other cities how to follow.
First of Manila is the first. Manila is the first.
It's not the first, but it's one of the most important cities. Simply because this is Manila. Is the capital. So, because the capital, so they have a special responsibility for that. That's why I'm saying again, we attach a great importance to the development of the cooperation between our two capitals.
Thank you.
To be frank, so I'm not authorized personally to invite Mr. Mayor. So the mayor of Moscow is authorized to invite Honorable Mayor to visit Russia. But the embassy will help arrange such a visit.
Very excited.
So once again, so
I am excited.
So I'm excited too. So it's time to go to Russia. It's time to discover Russia in general and to discover Moscow in particular. And I'm assuring all of you, if you go to Russia, if you go to Moscow, you'll see that we Russians and Filipinos, we have a lot in common. We have not only common problems, common challenges. We have many common positive things. So, we can and should be both friends and reliable partners.
Thank you.
Well, initial, during our initial talk with this Excellency, in line with our dreams and aspiration about making our school song,
public elementary, high school, and public elementary and high school buildings all over the city of Manila. As you remember, we gave a directive to harness renewable energy. And Russia, for that matter, is an energy superpower. They have all kinds of source of energy, and especially in their technologies also that we can adopt with regard to renewable energy. I would love to go to Moscow and to study this and bring it to Manila and share it and be form part of our policy in the next coming years in the city of Manila. So, yun most likely yung mangyayari. Bukod doon sa vodka. Thank you. Meron akong bagong tip ngayon. So anyway, ayoko na makabalayan pa si Ambassador. I-hatid ko lang, samahan natin. So maraming salamat sa inyong lahat.
Thank you.
Pagkatapos nito, photo office ng bagong Union President. Pagkatapos nito.